is, again, for new Head Mango fans, the Mango's International League of Fun.
Yeah.
Yes.
So I went to a MILF, which is basically just playing football. And at the MILF, I brought a like a 12-pack of beer. Like, as I, it was, I think it was a 12-pack of Michelob. And I was like, oh, Mango, I brought this beer. And he's like, oh, thanks. And he just took it and then put it in his car. That was it.
It's like an offering to the fucking Godfather, dude.
I thought we were going to crack it open.
Oh, no.
At least he said thanks.
I guess I have that for me.
Thanks, kid. We got Magi versus Spark. This is really exciting. This is also a loser's match. The past two matches we watched were losers, so the people who are eliminated are Axe and Fat Goku, actually, which is a crazy crazy happenstance.
And these are two trend graphs that are going up. Big money.
Indeed. Spark feels like a monster, and Magi feels like too... She feels too wild, and Spark tames that, you know, with his patience. And Magi is just like... I don't know. The way she went off yesterday, it makes me actually scared because of... Uh-oh, never mind. because the way that she punishes things like that.
Yeah. I think this matchup is interesting because I was kind of expecting this in the Plup Magi set. I was expecting to see the Sheik. So I've been curious since how Magi would handle this particular matchup. Now, obviously, Spark and Plup are going to play it way different. But I just kind of want to see what she's got in this matchup.
Yeah. Because even if it's different play styles, her follow-ups will be the same.
Yeah.
And her neutral might follow, you know, somewhat of the same graph. Now, I will say, I'm all in on Spark Stock.
I'm all in.
I think Spark Stock, it's going up. He's going to keep placing high. I don't think that's going to end anytime soon. All right? You know, I've been investing recently.
No jump.
I just spent $30,000 on Pokemon cards.
Yeah. You have
I haven't seen a big return on that. I haven't seen a big return on that.
All right, but I'm putting
the rest of my money on Spark.
Nice shine off the top.
For chat, he's talking shit on me because I said, yeah, I'm saving money. I think I'm going to start investing. Oh, and what? Pokemon cards.
This guy says to me, yeah, I'm thinking about investing in Pokemon cards. I've never done, like, stocks or anything, but I want my he says my guy says it's a good investment. No, Hugo, it's a good way to gamble, all right? That's what you're doing.
Yeah, just pissing away money. I was saying it's a way to gamble, but all the earnings are tracked, and that's what you don't want. You don't want Uncle Sam ringing your doorbell.
Yeah, not me. No.
Mm-hmm. Invest in the stock market.
So
I want to invest in Charizard. Fuck that.
You know Lizards what? Only. Really quick, though, I want to, like, Spark's game plan in the first minute or two of this set was to just kind of full hop Nair. And he stopped doing it, but it was really interesting because he seemed very persistent.
Yeah.
Like, this was an idea that was supposed to work.
Uh-oh. Like, oh, Facial no. said to do this thing, and yeah. then he started doing it, yeah.
Because I think it was recently found out that he didn't look at his opponents ever. Like, he's never
Dude,
actually...
Dude, that's...
And it makes sense to me, right? Because you look back at his run at that charity tournament where everyone was mad that he was trying so hard. I don't think he noticed that his opponents were having fun,
that
right?
That was so bad.
He was just playing Melee.
That was so bad for the Spark brand.
That was bad PR.
That was 5 years ago, and he's still eating the repercussions.
Now, this community never forgets. That's just
They really don't.
Here. Yeah.
He did even that up. But so it's a one. Oh, no.
Axe is still making pizza pog face.
Yeah. I will say the community lets, like, they hold on to memes like a fucking Rottweiler, dude.
Yeah.
And it's, I don't know. Take it or leave it.
Yeah.
At least it gives you a cultural membrane to absorb and enjoy the game. Oh, what a tech! Oh, my God. This is pretty spooky right now. Magi had a lead for pretty much the whole set.
Oh, wait a minute.
A lot of kills off the top.
Guys.
Another
up
one?
There,
another.
Oh,
wow. Yep.
Survived. I'm surprised.
She goes over out there.
Grab the ledge.
Wall jump.
Oh, good DI on that. Oh, covered everything.
Wow.
Okay. Very nice.
What an exchange.
Man, she's really just down a go. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Because he just super DI'd out on her dare.
Yeah, he.
She went to ledge, and then she still got the bear off that.
Yeah. Like, challenge her every step
like
of the way.
Magi, she's just
go ahead.
I feel like Magi, she got a lot better just overall.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
I think, like, a lot of times she would just, like, be just throwing out hitboxes and then just get hit and then die off it. Mm-hmm. But now it's, like... It's controlled chaos, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah, for
like,
sure.
Like she filters in, like, kind of like what I was saying about Sunsei earlier. I feel like Magi has learned that a little bit also. And it's hard with Falco, too, because you could definitely just, you know, rant, like, this could happen.
Yeah.
She might be dead, yeah.
Damn,
Spark
yeah.
also is amazing at that shit too. You can't. It's like really scary to challenge him on the ledge.
Absolutely.
But I know Magi's down two stocks, but all in all, I feel like she's gotten a lot better at just being okay with like when her opponent's just like in this situation, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Spark, on the other hand, he'll be down to trade. He's down to just, you know, do nairs at his shield.
Mm-hmm.
He always has a hitbox out to just, like, fuck your rhythm up.
Yeah, he plays the lead well.
Right.
Yeah, like trying to start every situation.
I don't know if you guys watched the Last Dance and Gary Payton was talking about Dennis Rodman, and then he was like, he's the fuck up person. He just fucks everything up. That's how I feel about Spark.
Are you saying that's Magi style or Spark style?
No, Spark.
Spark. Okay. He just fucks you up. Everything up. Your whole game.
I do like in the world where Spark is the Dennis Rodman of Melee.
Yeah, I know, right?
He calls up Kim Jong-un.
That's good for my investment.
I think it makes sense because he's like the defensive person, but also hyped. Like, no one would say that Dennis Rodman isn't hyped.
Yeah, and I feel like with Spark's defense, like, don't get me wrong, he'll be defensive, but there's times where he, like, definitely knows how to scrap and, like, get in the fray, because you have to against players that are, like, this fast sometimes. You can't, like, always sit and shield or always fucking shield grab and dash grab. You got to be able to draw, like, shit like that. Like, who does that?
Yeah, you can't be watching too much.
Don't be watching. Whoa, that was weird.
He knows when they get in the fray sometimes.
Damn, that was... He's had a couple F smashes.
Yeah, I'm very interested in the thought process behind this. Wow.
It has to be a mistake.
Tafo told him to do that one. Yeah, he listens to Face Roll and Tafo. Those are the only two.
When I was told in my Melee career and the great heights that I achieved was, hey, watch your opponent. Do not watch your own character. And it was like a landmark time for me.
I remember hearing that people do that, and I was a little mind blown.
Yeah, and then you feel better. You instantly get better when you start doing it.
I'd never do it.
And then Spark's just out here just looking at Sheik. Like,
I'm on Spark's side. I look at my sick pup the whole time. Floating around. She's got a big tummy.
But the difference is that Spark became good, you know?
Yeah, well, okay. You know.
We didn't become good, Ludwig.
Yeah, I know, because we had so many other activities we had to do.
Right, yeah. It's not our discipline problems or like commitment to anything. Yeah. You know?
If we had the time.
If your heart was in the right place.
Yeah, exactly.
It would have been guaranteed. I believe.
I just still holding on, maybe not for long.
Needle.
Oh,
for the ultra low.
A lot of quit outs.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no. Magi is not one to let the game finish. I think she's
It's only
quit
a few more seconds, though.
Yeah, I agree. You never know if your opponent's just going to accidentally fall off the stage, right? I'm not a rage quitter.
Hey, like, I have seen the. I want to see the match. That was Lucky, right? Lucky versus
Dark Emma.
Was it Dark Emma?
We commentated that.
Yeah.
I thought
it was going to be a huge, big deal. I thought it was going to be when Lucky, what did he do?
He killed Peach. Peach was slowly floating off stage, and then he just walked off
the
stage.
He stood up, fell off his fox fell off the stage, and then he stood up in real life celebrating, and then he died first.
Yeah.
And I was like, Ludwig, this is going to be the greatest, like, TO debacle of all time. And
I don't remember what happened.
And you're like, no. He fucked up, and Dark Emma takes the set. You're stupid.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, I guess
is
that's
that
true.
What happened?
Yeah, that's what happened.
There was more of a debacle with G Money coaching S-Fat.
Exactly.
Dude, that's so funny. The G Money coaching S-Fat.
Insane. Man, we got some good times, huh?
Yeah.
There's been some history.
I like sitting here and talking about all kinds of Melee memories for no reason at all in particular right now. There's no reason for me to specifically like talking about Melee memories right now.
Yeah.
But we've had some good ones.
But hey, you know what? Good times are free.
They are free, yeah.
Well, I just got it. I was like, damn, why the fuck is Hugs talking so weird? This dude's weird, man.
We're on FD. It's Magi. It's Spark. Really quick, you talked about Hugs, like, waiting for them to, you know, SD or whatever, like, not quitting out.
Mm-hmm.
Do you ever play Rocket League?
I've watched it, but no, I do not
play
it.
Okay, so in Rocket League, when you score a goal on somebody in the game, you can skip the replay of the goal that automatically plays.
Oh, yeah.
But if you don't want to, they have to watch it.
Oh, yeah.
And it's only like a couple seconds.
Both people have to click a button.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And so it's BM in Rocket League to make them watch the goal you scored on them.
Okay.
Yeah, I hammered down the button to skip.
So it'd be cool if in this game you can rage quit. You needed both to accept it.
Yeah.
Right, so they have to watch themselves fly off the top.
Yeah.
Or slowly die as Peach as she floats down. That'd be fire.
That'd be really.
Ooh, that was a good catch.
Nice.
That was a really good catch.
Is this Magi's counter
pick? Good stage.
Yeah, I do love bringing Sheik to FD.
As a puff?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What? I haven't thought about that matchup.
Sheik in general isn't very good here.
Like, why do you do it?
I just think Sheik becomes like kind of like a big dumb idiot that can't use platforms to slide around anymore.
Yeah,
yeah.
I mean, that's fair. I think platform play is what makes Sheik really fast and.
Is that everything that everyone creams about for Plup? Plup's shield drops are so fast.
I mean, he is sick on like battlefield. Yeah. He goes.
Then
he goes dumb.
That just goes away. Or you know, like Reno's movement and needles.
Reno literally doesn't know what to do without platforms.
It's
crazy. But yeah, no, absolutely. No, FD will definitely take away a lot of movement options for Sheik. And honestly, I think one of the big things is that Sheik is way easier to juggle. I think Sheik is kind of ass at getting back down.
Yeah, for sure.
That's a big advantage characters will have over Sheik.
Being directly below Sheik is pretty good for you.
Ooh, there's that full up there. It finally pays off.
So you get a lot of that on this stage.
Just kidding. Just kidding. God isn't real.
Well, that's just called no. That's just called no in the length of the up B.
Hey.
Ooh, that Nair's chill. You got to be careful.
That's the Shirigami. Oh, what?
Oh.
Yeah. Can I tell a very quick embarrassing story about myself?
Go for it.
I drove Reno to an SSS once because he needed a ride because he was like in the area where I was. Mm-hmm. And I was like just starting out the game and stuff, and I knew Reno was like a good player. Mm-hmm. So we're just like talking and stuff, and like there's this big awkward silence in the car, and I'm just like, how do I, like, what should I do after I laser?
That's what you asked.
Yeah. I could hear him just, like, roll his eyes, dude.
Every good player hates that question.
Oh, my God. Because I played Falco, and he's like, well. And he tries to, like, give me an answer, like, be nice.
Because you're giving
like,
him a ride, right?
Yeah. I give him a ride. He can't get out. He can't leave.
Yeah. You pull over to ask?
Yeah.
Yo, real talk for a moment, man.
On the highway, so you just can't go anywhere.
Looking back, I'm like, God, I'm so fucking stupid. I could just practice the game. Anyway, Spark with a boop on the nose.
Yeah, and as much as I tried to talk about how Sheik's not good, Spark just won it. And that's why I invested.
Yeah,
yeah man. That's why you invested in Spark and Charizard.
So you're choosing the Spark stock over the Face Roll stock?
Yeah, 100%.
Why?
Why?
Spark stock is like a penny stock. It's like younger and vibrant, and it had it has a bit of
you can't talk
past.
Like a fucking stockbroker because you have a mustache now. You cannot do that.
I don't know what you're talking
you
about.
You don't know anything about stocks.
We can
you're
expect
acting like
a
you do,
6-8%
and it's fucking
return.
Stupid. God damn this. I hate this.
What?
It's looking like a bull market, right?
Triggered.
I'm just saying. You have a mustache, dude. You
when the market crashes, the spaceys fall first.
Fucking buy Pokemon cards at your goddamn stockbroker, dude. Anyway, Magi definitely got Spark in the corner now.
That's all
so
the moves,
mad.
Bro.
Hey, thank you. Thank you, Brandon.
Up air? Yep.
I respect it.
So it goes to show how good this stage is. Magi, even though she lost on the last game, still insisting on going back, which I think is the smart move.
Yeah,
you could kind of, like, the way you're going to lose on this stage is typically, like, you ran into some bad mix-ups, right? You're Falco, you die quick, you ran into some bad mix-ups.
Yeah.
It's still the better stage. Worth going back.
Oh, what?
In general,
that
too, this matchup,
what's
I actually fucking hate this matchup with Falco.
Yeah?
Oh, really?
But,
why is that that you feel that way?
Because I feel like Sheik has an answer for Shine every time you use it. And I feel like in this matchup, sometimes it's like, obviously it's good when it hits, but to get it to hit, it's like, damn.
It is a huge struggle.
That's just my opinion.
No, I think that's a shared frustration with a lot of Falco players in general. It's just, it's a struggle to get the shine, and maybe that's how it should be, I guess, but I feel you.
Yeah.
Oh, well, they can't
it's
hit
their
one.
Shut the fuck up, Hugo. I'm still wrong.
Oh. I love that. He says
it's
well.
It's one of those matchups where it's like, if you're playing on point with Falco,
dude, I hate that shit. Falco has all the tools.
Bro, you hard. Got the yeah, tools. At the end of the he day, does. Bro, he glass does. Cannon, any does. Single, any shine, baby. And
yeah,
all it takes
one stock
grab.
Is not a lead, bro. Fucking. Yeah. You don't know what you got until it's gone.
Can't shit where you eat, man. Can't shit where you eat. Rome wasn't built in the day. So fast.
I fucking hate, this shit.
I do think the way Spark plays it in particular makes it really, really tough for you to get like a true opening on him. You know, yeah.
Oh,
yes,
sir. Like,
ooh.
That was so nice. Too bad she didn't get it.
I think both FD games, to be fair, Magi has SD'd.
Yeah, yeah,
they're not playing on poise.
Yeah, they're, thanks Spark for the return fire.
This particular set has shown so much like really sick counterplay, specifically from Magi, is what I'm noticing. Is like her SDI on that jab earlier, where she like went to the other side of Sheik, and then the jab reset, and then that like just tech wall jump back air. It's like what we saw with Axe and Sunsei. It's like just the
the
layers.
Yeah, I feel like this stock Magi suddenly played differently.
Okay.
So she's seeing he's just shielding, right? And like waiting for the aerial, so she's like, all right, bet. Wave, land back, laser.
The problem is she didn't get much off of it.
Yeah. Nah, yeah, she didn't.
And then he just got one opening.
Yeah, it'd be like that.
Imagine her tournament she's stock, really, actually.
Like, yeah, this could be everything.
She's doing a good job at like baiting him to do something out of the shield, which I think is like how you beat Sheik.
That was a gimme. I didn't think that was...
Actually,
I mean, first time she's gone for that, right?
Yeah, just the roll up, the raw hold.
Occasionally, you got a raw hold.
Yeah.
Sheik recovery is so weird and good.
Game 5. Sucks you
it's
can't
like,
use
sometimes
meme tags.
It's really good, sometimes it's really bad.
Yeah.
It should be on paper.
I think both of these characters are like that.
Bad, but these Sheik players have managed to find a way to mix it up, so it's just...
Oh, you think Sheik's recovery is generally bad?
As a character, yeah. I think it's not a great recovery.
Really? I think it's pretty good.
Oh, well, because the tradition was that you're going to get your best damage on Sheik when they're trying to recover. Like, it was pretty much a guaranteed rinse and repeat.
Yeah.
If not for a kill, at least for, like, 80%, right? But I think as of late, the Sheiks have improved greatly at recovering, so that area of the game where you excelled against Sheik is just no longer guaranteed.
Yeah.
I agree. Especially Falco, too. Both of these characters, I think. Like, there's this meme that Falco's recovery is trash, but
good.
I think that's just fire, bro.
Yeah. I think it's better than Fox's, to be honest. Because,
I don't know about that.
There's no cap.
I can see that, though. I can definitely see
I am not capping.
Is that usually because the side B hits people? And
no, they go down when they get hit by side B. That's what
I'm
saying.
Yeah, that's
You were talking so much wise truth until now, and now I don't know what to think.
No, someone's going to agree with me. What? Not the Falco players.
Who's going to agree with you?
They like to wham.
This is like if Socrates said tits instead of ass.
It's not.
All his work would be thrown out.
They would burn the library.
It's definitely debatable, I think, but I still think Fox is
Yeah.
But Falco's recovery is still really good.
It's good. It's like, but no Falco feels that way, so maybe it's not real, you know?
Well, Brandon.
You haven't even asked him.
What's up?
You just asked Brandon.
Brandon's
just saying that
because
he doesn't want to start an argument, but I know what he thinks.
I guarantee you, Mango.
He just said he thinks it's good. No. And you were in the same bracket today, yesterday, and he won the bracket that you lost round one at.
Slide, to be fair, I've been head ass about Falco. I understand, bro. Every Falco needs a head ass phase, bro.
All right. I guess I'm still in my phase.
Yeah, every player.
Brandon, is this phase usually 4 years? Or
I don't know.
Get me out of here, dude.
This phase is
I'm being attacked.
However long you want it to be.
Yeah.
Who do you think? Okay, here's a hot topic. Who do you think is the most head ass, but the best player?
While being head ass?
While being head ass.
Swedish delay.
What a curveball.
Is he head ass?
Do you think it's not head
Sheik?
Ass for him to go Luigi against Hungrybox and not think it's weird? Like, he thinks it's just a straight
that
up.
That was
like,
hype. You can't deny
it's
that.
Still head ass.
It was great. No, it was great, but it was head ass. Like, I think he's very head ass.
Okay.
That's not. What does head ass mean? I'm not saying he's dumb, right? That's not what I'm saying.
No, I think it just means
just very stubborn,
like,
and
you know, head but also ass.
It's wild shit. I don't know.
Oh no, Suck and Shine.
But wait a minute, Needlekin. Yeah, Needlekin. Yeah,
all the way up. Pretty clean. Magi once again on her tournament stock.
I will say it was sick. Spark did a dash attack into grab, a turnaround grab.
What's the follow up here?
Good investment.
He can't really do much. Insane that he uppies on the stage.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, the roll. Caught him lacking.
Grab there.
Grab the ledge again.
Oh, no. Yeah, she wave dashed back and then jumped because she was like, wait.
Yeah.
Why did he have smash again? Crazy.
He didn't mean that.
She's got to close this out now. Yeah. Can't risk
it. Again.
Nice. There it is. All right. Here
this
we go.
This is it. Last stop.
Last stop for either of these.
Situation.
Yeah. It's the opening. Getting the chip damage. Oh, no. There's a knockdown. And staying counterplay.
Wow.
Shine.
I do love a down smash. That could have been a game changer getting down smash, but it also might cost you the game.
Good job not jumping.
Cute.
Dodging that needle.
Damn.
Oh my god, Fair is crazy.
Getting one
might
more
be
chance.
It.
Oh, she's back. Oh, that's it.
Trade.
Wow.
Man, that cannot be on purpose, yeah. Obviously.
That was crazy.
No one's trying to jump from ledge
with crazy
Fair.
Legs.
Yeah, unfortunate to see because I thought Magi was playing really well this weekend. Did you guys see that crazy combo at the end yesterday? It's been all over.
Yeah, it was insane. I watched the whole set. It was wild.
Yeah.
Wild.
But, you know, Spark, I would say I agree the set wasn't the cleanest between both players. I think they both felt like they could have played better. But Spark getting another chance to fix that in the bracket, and unfortunately Magi is going to be out. But great showing for her this whole weekend.
Yeah, I think she'll never, like, she'll always have that combo, you know? It's like when I Falcon
Punch. Isn't that why you
Aiden.
Play Falco?
What, yeah, to get that? Yeah,
you
that
always
kind
get
stuff.
That combo, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. But yeah.
No one plays Puff for that reason, I'll tell you what.
Toussaint, maybe? Maybe Toussaint.
You've gone for a near rest in your time.
Yeah.
I saw your
that
rest
doesn't
on Zane.
Go all over Twitter. The only reason that goes on Twitter is because it's on Zane's dumbass who cannot beat my Puff for the life of him. Give that man 20 lives. Still can't pour soccer. Man.
Oh, man. Oh. What mark did you get your training on?
It was Cripple Cow.
Crippled Cow from AZ.
Yeah, Crippled Cow from AZ.
Oh, wow.
You say yass that, man.
You see yass him around? Him and floats, huh?
Just pick him up, drop him.
Yeah. Hoping. So I've seen this plenty of times where people don't play that clean early in bracket, and then they start to clean it up as it goes on.
Yeah.
All you really need is that small boost of confidence, that extra chance to change it up. So we'll see if Spark ends up getting that here. But we can see here that 7.4 to 7.5. Honestly, I think that's high for both because I think that goes to show the
that means Slop Town.
Yeah, that means they were both playing like shit.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Now, what has the number been at so far this weekend, just generally?
Like damage, 1,000.
Yeah.
Openings, like 6 to 7. Five to six.
Yeah,
here,
see.
It's like doubled on.
Yeah. That's cool that the stats can kind of illuminate that with info.